Hello, everybody. I'm Eustace Farmer, and welcome to episode 4 in our Sandy Bay vlog series. So I'm just taking an early stroll on the beach with our little friend, as you saw run by. His name is Mux. He's the stray dog that you saw in the very first pre-release Sandy Bay video. And I've got my daughter, Isabella, on the GoPro camera here. So why don't you say hello to everybody, Isabella?
Hi, everybody.
What we're trying to do is we're trying to lure Mux over to the Landy Kid Tasty Burgers cart. As a way to try to make friends with him and gain his confidence, I thought if I threw him a hot dog or a hamburger or something, then he would kind of look for me every time we came down here and eventually maybe have him as one of our farmhands back at the farm, and he wouldn't be a stray down here any longer. But we'll see how that goes. He's pretty independent, so it might be a long time coming, if ever at all. So in the meantime, we're just going to come down and visit Mux whenever we can, and he's a pretty lively, playful fella. So, all right. So, one other side note that I'd like to mention. When you're a YouTuber, especially one like Landy Kid, where you're putting videos out day in and day out, and even with his hectic travel schedule between the UK and Canada, he still manages to get out his content in a very timely manner and do his live streams. Does a great job at it. But what I'm getting at here is to be recognized like this. And let me show you. They even have David put his logo on the side of the cart here. There you go. This is fantastic. And I just like to say congratulations to Landy Kid, because this is a little tip of a hat by a very talented and, in my opinion, awesome map maker, Oxygen David. When you do things for David and he gives back like that, that really lets you know that your hard work has been paying off. So Landy Kid deserves this, and it may not seem, like I said, a big deal to you guys, but this is a little something that, you know, it's a farming sim YouTuber's dream. So congratulations, Landy Kid. You certainly deserve it. And David gave you a very nice view out your office window. I mean, look at that, guys. There's a little motorboat passing by the rising sun this morning. So, yeah. So, great job on the camera, Isabella. So, we're going to go ahead and get to work. We've got a really busy day ahead of us here. We're going to be using a new palleting system, and we're going to be doing some work for some local farmers, and I'll explain it all to you once I get back to the farmyard. But first, what I'd like to do is I'd like to show you a little video clip that we did over the weekend of what we've been up to here in our little mini vacation down here in the Devon Coast. So I'm going to go ahead and play that for you, and then I'll meet you back at the farm, and we'll get to work. Alrighty, so I hope you enjoyed that. So we're starting off back here in the cattle field, and that's for a couple of reasons. One is, just look at that gorgeous morning sun coming up. It's 6:15 in the morning here in Devon. So the first reason is, when we're done doing our contracting work, we're going to come back here and we're going to bale up some silage for our own farm. So I'm going to show you how to use that new palleting machine to bale up the silage. So it's going to be really cool. And then, I don't know if some of you have noticed, unless you've really got into exploring the farm, you're going to find a few things that Oxygen David has done that you may not expect. But here's one of them. There's a little parking place back here, a little shed, and you could put, you know, longer items in here or, you know, pile things one in front of the other. I found it a nice place to put the manure spreader out of the way, and it's near the animals that generate manure. Okay, so on with the main event. While we're walking here, we'll just walk and talk. I'm also testing out a new microphone. It's called the HyperX Revolver. I noticed with my Turtle Beach Recon 60 headset, I had to really talk loud and have the microphone very close to my mouth in order to get a decent audible level out of it. And then it would redline in Adobe Premiere Pro, and I would have to constantly back everything back down. So this one was a bit getting used to. At first I was like, oh my gosh, this is terrible. I hate it. I'm going to return it. But then I got up this morning and I decided to give it another chance, and I found settings that I can tweak. So I've tweaked a lot of settings and I can further tweak them. But I'd like to know from you folks how you think the audio sounds. My voice compared to the in-game sounds, the quality, so forth and so on. I would really appreciate it. Like I said, this is a $120 headset. So if it's not going to work out, then I would rather return it. but you let me know, and we can tweak things as we go along. Alrighty, so I got the JCB loaded up here, and we did get a healthy influx of cash, and that was from a wealthy philanthropist investor from the United States that I had mentioned in an earlier video. His name is Gerald Griswold. He's better known as Grizzly Bear Sims. He's got a YouTube channel as well, and he does a lot of farming, especially American farming. So do go over and check him out. He is a member of the Three Dudes Gaming Network, our network forum, and he's an administrator on there as well. I'm happy to have him. So his link is down in the description along with the others. So you're going to find a very new member of ours that's just starting out. He's a great guy. His name is Matt, Matthew Danner, and he goes by the screen name of Doughboy. His link is down in the description as well. Please do check him out and give him some support. We would really appreciate it. He's a Three Dudes Gaming Network member. And then, of course, we have our usual fantastic lineup of guys. We have TBF Gaming, Chris Bond, Wheels247, Multi Mickey, and Species7. So please do check them all out. So anyway, here's the check. Jerry wrote us a $3 million investment check. So we've put that money to excellent use, and we've bought a whole bevy of new equipment. So this and more you're going to see turn up here. Added some additional fencing, got a little barbed wire action going there. Fergus said we should electrify it, but you know what will happen. I'll be the one getting electrocuted, not the people that deserve to be electrocuted. All right, so we've got our tandem bale trailers. We're going to need those. And then here's the pallet machine. So if you purchase one of these models, there's one thing that you need to be aware of. It's just like the wood chip model. So you're going to get inside of it, and if you have the parking brake mod, which you're going to see an extensive review on that on Grizzly Bear Sims' channel, so do keep an eye on his channel for that. He's going to show you all about that. You're going to have to take the parking brake off of this as well. It considers it a vehicle. So you do that, and then you'll be working the machine, turning it on and so forth by jumping into it. Once you get it all set, then you can jump out of it, and then you get into your tractor and you can move it around. So that's what we're going to be doing. And we got our New Holland telehandler. I had the Merlot telehandler on the farm. We have since given that back to the dealer. One of the reasons being is the wheels were very soft. And off story, they were clipping through the ramps, so I couldn't get it on the trailer. Didn't happen with the New Holland or the Manitou, so we chose one of those. And we have a new bale grab for square and round bales, so we're going to be trying that out. So we've got everything we need, I think. All right, so let's jump in and get over to Field 16, where the farmers have left the spoils of their harvest over there for us to pallet some of it up. Alrighty, we'll put our beacon lights on because we've got quite a convoy here today. I hope nobody gets stuck back there. Now let me put the parking brake on. I want to show you something. So there we go, it's on. If you hit anything, it's going to let you know with that audible beep that you need to release the parking brake. And anybody that's been following my channel along from Farming Simulator 15, you'll know that is one of my nemesis, is that I always forget to take off the parking brake. A beautiful morning to be doing some on-field palleting work. It's a beautiful morning to do anything in Devon. Now let's hope that these two gentlemen follow us along here. We're going to have to stay towards the middle of the road. That's why we have our beacons on. But it's a good thing it's early yet over here, so we're not going to get any commuter traffic down this road. We don't usually ever anyway. Okay, so we're going to take this left here. I'm kind of taking the scenic route because I started off the wrong way. No sense in pretending. So we'll just come down this way. Get right back on track. Hopefully our gentleman won't get stuck. I'm more worried about the bale trailers. These are tight roads to navigate for a tandem bale trailer. So at the end of this road, we just take a right, and it'll be right over on the side there. There's Her Majesty's Royal Air Force flying overhead on the job. Keeping the skies safe. Thank you very much to all the wonderful men and women who serve in our armed forces in the UK and America. Much appreciated your dedication and your bravery. Hats off to you. So we should be just over this bridge. Excellent. There it is. I can see the piles ahead. So I did tell the farmers that this machine will not do dried grass. It will not do hay. It will do regular cut grass. So you can bale, you know, wet grass, but not dried. And then it does sugar beets and potatoes and a whole host of other things. And what I can do is I could show you in the catalog. But let me get these gentlemen situated first. And I'll be right back at you. Alrighty. So we've got everybody where they need to be. We'll shut off our beacons here. Now, you're going to need a lot of room. And I'll show you why. There's two ways you can do this with this particular apparatus. It has a feature which it will grab the stuff from the side and it will load it in for you. It's like a suction. Or you can use a wheel loader or whatever kind of bucket and manually put it in yourself into the hopper in the back. So we'll do it this way first because I have those bale grabs on and I want to see how they do grabbing pallets, just as a little experiment. Let's put our parking brake on, and we'll get out. Ooh, Geronimo. There we go. And we'll go ahead around the side here and open up our control panel. So let's go ahead and we'll start it up like a normal vehicle. Okay, now that we have that done, you're going to turn on the unit itself. So you're going to hit B. Now, you're going to have to work this machine as far as when it's doing the pallets. So we're just going to fill a little bit up here. So let's pull ahead. There we are. you can just turn it on and then let it do its thing and then shut it off and pull forward if you don't want to fill it up. So this is potatoes. Now this machine by no means is a fast process. I think the modder did a wonderful job. And like I said, if you're going to do a whole pile, you could just stay there. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's get started. So the first thing you're going to do is enable pallet creation. That's going to be letter I. And as you see, it's going to drop them down. And if you look in the right corner, you can see, now 39% is the fill rate inside the hopper. It doesn't have anything to do with the pallet capacity. So this holds, I want to say, 6 bags. But just when you think it's going to stop, then it goes again. So give it a minute. But as you see, it's moving right along. And we'll have one more bag at the top. And there we go. And just for good measure, now see, it's still filling up that bag. You want to make sure it's full. And there we go. So now, what do you do with it so you can do the next pallet? You hit letter X. And that's going to push it out just like so. Hit letter X again to bring it back in. Don't create a new pallet with that thing out, because it'll get really stuck in there. And it'll start making a new one. Now, if you want to be safe, you can turn off the pallet creation while you're pushing the first pallet out and then turn it back on. But it, like I said, the mod works brilliantly. Now, for some strange reason, when I first started using this particular machine, I got an error and it said invalid fill type of compost at BGA. But since, I don't know, today it doesn't have the error. So, I got it on the original Goldcrest map as well. I don't know. Maybe it found what it needed. But it's working great. So I am going to do a mod review on this as well. So that being said, I will leave a link down in the description. I'm going to warn you that this is a share mod download. And for some of those that think share mod is not as bad, it is. I got some pretty bad pop-ups. So what I'm going to do is, like I said, I love the mod. I'm going to leave it up to you whether or not you want to download it. It's, you know, your responsibility to make sure that you have good antivirus software and to make the decision on top of that whether or not you still want to download it. And it says we have 7% left back in the hopper there, so we'll just let it do its thing. So this works the same way for sugar beets, so we don't have to do that on cam. So we'll shut that down, close our control panel up. There we go. Okay. So now we'll just load a couple onto the bale trailer, and then I'm going to go and deliver them to market, so I'll be right with you. Okay. So tested the bale grab, really nothing short of brilliant. So it works on round, square bales as well, and pallets. So now, would you really want to use it on pallets? I mean, because you're grabbing the outside, and sometimes if you're stacking them tightly, that could pose a problem. But if you're on a budget, and you don't want to have bale forks hanging around, then here you go. Like I said, if you're baling all the kinds of different things and you're going to have these anyway, instead of bringing a set of pallet forks along also, there you go. Very easy to stack. I have auto load on this one, but the front one does not. See if it'll just, there we go, you can even pick it up like that. Nice. So these bale grabs are in the in-game mod hub menu, so give them a try. And I'll just show you over here. I'll place it on the other one, just so you can see that they place down very nicely. No jumping around or any kind of funny business like that. But that's one thing I do like about using these bail grabs, is that you really have a more fluid, precise motion. You know, you don't have to fight getting the forks out from the pallet. And then if you get a little something crooked like that, you know, you can go ahead and adjust it in the more ungentlemanly fashion, like so. So this will make bale stacking and pallet moving a pleasure. Whether you do it totally manual or a little automated, it's going to really help you out a lot. Okay, so like I said, unfortunately they dumped all this hay over here, and we cannot do anything with it in its current state like that. We'll have to use a traditional baler. So I'm going to give them a call and talk to them about do they want to have it wrapped up in the coming days for silage and some other forms. So we'll see about that. All right, so I'm going to get this all set, and I'll be back with you in just a little bit when we're going to go and run these down to the market and get back to the farm and do our silage bales. So see you in a minute. All righty, so I'm back at the main farm in the cattle field here, and I loaded it up with silage, and I found it easier to figure out when the bale was done when it's not simultaneously loading. So I make sure that I get a full bale before I push it out. So what I'm going to do is, these are full completed bales. I'm going to put one in a trailer so you can see. There's one thing that I did notice with this. Let's go ahead and load it up. It doesn't matter so much for the silage bales, but it could impact your ratios for your mixed ration as far as the grass bales go. Because the grass bales I found when I experimented with this yesterday, they were 3,000, and the standard in-game ones are 4,000. So let's see, what did that give us here? Yeah, so the bales that come out of here are 3,000. So being that the mixing wagons are based off of the 4,000 unit bales, that could be a little bit of an issue. I don't know. I did not make mixed ration with these yet. I mean, like I said, the silage, it doesn't matter because you do that last and you just top off. So that's not going to be an issue. And but for the other bales, it will be. So that's just something to be aware of. Alrighty. So we'll go ahead and load one of these up on the trailer. So another thing that I found, you don't want to have an auto-loading trailer too close to this thing when it's pushing out the bales, because, you know, you think, oh, how ingenious, you could just grab them as they come out. Well, I don't know. It does something to it, it confuses it, and it stops putting out pallets. So I found that out when I was doing the potatoes. There we go. But as you see, they're nice and solid. They work great. As far as baling goes, is this any advantage? No. And even the mod author himself said that, you know, it is a slow process. For palleting, I think it's fun. I think it's a nice, efficient way to make pallets. Probably won't use it for baling because, let's face it, I can make silage bales round and square now with the Coon DLC, and I could do it much faster. You can make any bale with the baling equipment much faster. But I think it's going to be good for pallets, and, I mean, if you want to have some fun, you can use it to do silage bales as well. Because, hey, they do look good. I mean, they look really legit. The plastic looks legit. Did a fine job. He really did. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and make a silage bale for you, and I'm going to let the camera roll through the whole process so you can see the length of time that it takes. So let's go ahead and we'll press letter I to enable. And it drops down, and you watch the little meter ticking away there, the capacity going down. And whenever it stops, that's when you push it out. And you got to give it a little time, because you see it stops and it starts, because it's kind of measuring. So like I said, having a lot of fun with it. really, really awesome. So one thing I could mention while we're waiting here, cattle and crops. It's been delayed a few weeks. The developers have said that there are some things that they would like to work out before they release the game. They're not quite happy with it in its current state, so they want to do a little bit more refinement before they release a early access beta version. And it looks like it's done. Push it out. So, that's it, guys. Like I said, I could do grass bales for you, but I think you get the gist. It's a bale, just like this. Works the same way. Let me show you how it all looks in the catalog. Okay, so you're going to find it in the miscellaneous section. And it's right here, the Flegel pallet filling system. It's $54,000. And it does potatoes, sugar beets, milk, fertilizers, solid and liquid, and pig feed, wood chips, silage, grass bales, and loose grass. So I'm not quite sure if it does straw. Alrighty, so I know if you take a grass bale and dump it in there, it'll change it back to its particular form. And this, no. So it does not do straw. Oh, there you go. It tossed it across the the parking lot. So it's not going to do straw for you. So, like I said, it's a really fun piece of equipment to use. I think it is pretty awesome for pallets, and it seems to do a little bit of a faster job with the pallets. As far as baling goes, I don't see myself using it. Maybe just to do silage bales, because they just look really cool. But to have you sit here while I'm doing it, that's not going to work. But, you know, definitely a mod I plan to keep. Definitely a mod that I can recommend. Like I said, unfortunately, it's a download through a share mod website. So, you know, you're taking your chances. Make sure you have great antivirus software and, you know, really think about it. I'll be quite honest, if it wasn't for the fact that I'm a farming simulator YouTuber, I probably wouldn't have downloaded this mod. As soon as I saw that it is not an original mod host or link or something like that, when I saw that it's linked to a shady mirror site, I would forego it. I think it's brilliant, but I don't think it's worth the price of compromising your PC. The ultimate decision is up to you guys, okay? So I'll leave a link to the download site in my description, and I'm also going to leave a link to the modder's YouTube channel, because he did a video on this showing how to work everything, and he's got instructions in the description detailed and laid out exactly how to use this machine. And with that being said, I don't think it's warranted or necessary that I do a mod review on it. So being that he's already gone through the trouble and the time to showcase his own mod and give detailed instructions, which I think is fantastic, I think that, you know, people should go over there and have a look at that. All right. So until we meet again, my friends, please play hard, live well, and by all means, please take great care of yourself, okay? And bye-bye for now.